everyone, and welcome back to another Build Showcase video. We are still in Sachin's map, and we're still in the first village. I just want to show you the remaining cottages that we have here, just so we can have a few more ideas, get some inspiration. So let's start off with this one on the end. This one has basic white vibrant clay and black vibrant clay, and it's another Tudor style house. Now, there's quite a lot of houses that I see like this in Canterbury, so this is a house style that I'm somewhat familiar with, and it just looks absolutely brilliant. You could have one of these that would have like a shop on the bottom floor. These seem kind of like, yeah, these seem like shops. They've got nice little shop windows that you could put stuff in the windows, and it looks great. Again, this doesn't have an interior, but it doesn't really matter. All he's done here is he's just got this normal white vibrant clay, and he's just put strips of black clay on top in this formation. Very simple lines, very basic, and it just works so well. Look at that. No fancy shapes and buildings of weird, you know, weird corners and bits sticking out. It's as basic as just putting some strips on, and it looks fantastic. Moving on, another thing, it's just basic again, a very flat wall, but what he's done is he's used these on the corners. So we've got some classic sand bricks and some classic bricks, and all he's done is he's put them together like this. Like, let's just get that up there. So he has this going up in the corner, and then every other one he builds up like that. He's actually doing it alternatively. If we can see here, he goes one, two, like that. So if we have it on that side, like that, and then all he does is he just fills it in with the bricks, and you get this awesome corner. Now, I haven't done that too well. I've actually done that completely wrong. Let's try it again on that side. Let's see. There we go. There, there, and there. And that's how he gets this really awesome corner. Check that out. That is just, it's very basic. It's, you know, it's very basic design, but it works. It works great. Again, not having to use all this fancy 3D stuff. It's something that I've been scared of attempting myself for fear of it being too basic. But now that I see it here and a collection of them together, I realize that it's not that big of a problem. And especially when you're building a village, not everything is going to have so much detail in it, especially when you're building in Minecraft. A lot of you have to kind of worry about where your time is spent. And I think the time has been spent very well here. The interesting thing about this house, apart from this little awning that we have here, which is very cool, which has the same texture as the roof, is the roof has a different shape. We go up standard like this, and then it starts going up too high, too high, too high, with big, massive chimney like that. And it just looks so cool. It just adds another bit of difference to this house. And note how all these houses are different, but they fit in so well. That's the great thing about British architecture, is we sort of have a lot of, especially in the older buildings, there's lots of just random stuff dotted in. We also have these with the brown windows, another thing that you could see a lot of in Britain. These seem to be slightly more modern than these other ones, but again, it looks fantastic. Again, with the chimney, not using the standard brick that most of them have. We actually see most of these have brick. You may notice those ones are slightly different, this one's slightly different. That's another tip with British building, is just, you know, just mix out the things a bit. They don't all have to have the same color roofs, they don't have to have the same color chimneys, and it works. It works absolutely fantastically. We also have this over here. These buildings are interesting because this one, they all have these little windows downstairs as a main window, but there's no other window there apart from this one up in the roof. And it comes out of the roof like that. It looks very cool indeed, with a nice little, I guess they're still sash windows, but it's a very British window design. Very simple to do and very effective. Again, we have another one. This is actually sort of a semi-detached because, well, it's at the end of a terrace. And then we have the middle terrace here, again in the same one. But then this one is a bit more extravagant. Again, that's another weird thing, is a lot of variety you may see even on the same set of terraces. How one house may be double the size, or, you know, something like that. It's weird. Again, I think the best thing that you can do if you're trying to replicate a British town is to just look through Street View and just see what you can find. Look through Canterbury. Look through places like that. There's a lot of cool things that you can spot inside of there. Again, nothing in the interiors, but it doesn't matter. There you can see outside of those windows. But they look great with this little bit sticking out of the building. That adds the 3D-ness. But you don't have to have 3D-ness everywhere else. Everywhere else is pretty much flat, and that's fine. That's cool. It works fantastically. We've actually got windows going all the way around the side here. Have we got them on the back? Nothing on the back. But again, Building in Minecraft, you don't have to have all the details everywhere. Again, you've got to pick your time, pick your battles of where you're going to be building. And again, these lovely hedges just added to this edge. It sets it off perfectly. And also with the path here, we also have these. These are collapsible blocks, which are used as the slope to go down to a crossing. And it is just so... I don't know why... I'm pretty sure I tried this before, and I don't know why I didn't go through with it. But it looks fantastic. And we've also got this little path here with this little greenery. It looks brilliant. We've got the double yellow lines here. It's all very British. But there we go. That is it for this video, showing off these few cottages. Well, we'll be covering a lot more stuff in this map. There's a few more different cottage sets I want to show you, some more individual buildings, plenty more to see, but that's going to be it for this video. So if you've enjoyed this video, please let me know by rating, commenting, and subscribing. Oh, check that view out there. We've got those houses along there, the Tudor one in the background, and just over yonder, just over there, we can see the church. That looks absolutely fantastic. But there we go, guys. That is it. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you all next time. Goodbye!